top, Steez.
Tiger style.
No.
Right.
About to get a little fish on that thing. You know what I'm saying?
Probably some local shrimp.
You know, right here in the Charlie O.
Yeah, local shark steak. A little swordfish, something we can marinate.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, we're about to get this shark steak down in here, man. Three nice fillets, probably Mako shark. Local baby love.
And then
we're
gonna get some shrimp. We're gonna do like a shrimp and plantain hush puppy. So we're about to.
Kitchen now, man. We about to let Chef Marcus Middleton do his thing with everything he got going on here. Go ahead, Marcus, do your thing, brother.
All right, so right here we about to do an aioli for the hush puppies. But before that, we got to do some key important things prior. So with these plantains, we got to get the water boiling. And what I like to do is step over here. We're going to put salt in. You got to season everything you do. You got to season in layers, baby. And I got some salt. 3 pinches. They're roughly about 3 tablespoons of that, but you just want enough to kind of season what you got going on. All right, so we're going to make the aioli. So starting off, we have some Duke mayonnaise, we have a lime, a lemon, we have some grape tomatoes, parsley, mint, basil. All right, so we have here, we're going into using a lime, and I'm going to cut this lime vertically because it's easier to squeeze for me. And what I'm using to cut this lime with is a Middleton made knife, made from Charleston, South Carolina. It's actually not from Charleston. It's from a small place named St. Stephen. That's roughly about an hour from where we stand, but it's in the country. I'm going to use about roughly, I'll say maybe 2 tablespoons, but I'm going to squeeze it naturally. You know what I'm saying? So we're going to come in here with a lime.
Tell us why you put that lime in there, man.
The acid, man, it's going to bring out, it's going to brighten this thing. It's going to actually make this sauce pop that adds to this plantains that we're about to make. Now that we have our lemon, we have our lime juice in here, I'm going to add about 1/2 cup of Duke's mayonnaise. The reason why I like Duke's has its own tangy vibe as well, but we wanted to kick it up a notch. So that's roughly about 1/2 cup right there. We're going to get that in there. So now we're going to add some of our knife cuts. Some of the herbs I'm going to be using, I have mint right here, I have basil, and I have parsley. So the type of cuts that I'm going to do with these mint and basil is a chiffonade. And a chiffonade is pretty much cutting in small ribbons. So right here, what we can do, we can kind of fold all our mint right here, roll it like so. Right here, within cutting, you want to use like an oval motion. So you kind of want to go like this right here, you know what I'm saying? So, and this is going to actually let your knife slide through your product.
I love these knives right here. It's brother made. They give you this little crevice where your finger can choke up on it, man. You come down on and get that really nice fine chiffonade like Marcus was doing. Probably the best knives in the Charleston area, hands down.
Hands down. It's comfortable. It's light, too. So, like, if you really want to balance it, you know what I'm saying? Come in this area right here. And look, it balances off right there. I'm going to drop it.
Bruh.
Alright, so we have our finished product of the chiffonade mint, and we're going to chiffonade some basil. So we're going to do the same exact thing. We're going to roll that up. Oh yeah. You see that? And then I'm going to take some, we can put it in there as well. And we can't forget about the parsley. So right here we have a pickled peppercini pepper, which is from Fresh Future Farm. So right here I'm just gonna kind of mince this. I'm using this because since we pickled it, it has this little kick, it has this little spice, and my man right here, Chef Del Juan, he pickled it. So, you know, he got all this little magic in that thing, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
You gotta make love to it. So that's gonna go in right here. So this is our aioli right here. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna whisk this right here. All right. And then right here, we got that right there. So you can add a few other things if you would like. You know, if you wanted capers or whatever, or if you wanted to thicken this up, or if you want a little more, add a little more herbs to it to actually pop out a lot more. So another thing we have to do, we gotta add salt. So right here, I'm just gonna take a little pinch, a two finger pinch. Take right here, we're gonna salt bay that thing. Season everything, gotta be seasoned. Right here, we're gonna add some cayenne to actually give it a little kick. Not too much, people. So don't do this at home, what I'm doing. It's almost been too much, but that's that love. See, that's that flick of the wrist.
That's the flick of the wrist. That hot fire.
So we're gonna mix that thing. And another reason why I added that cayenne too, I wanted to pop out with some a little red flakes within it. And then also, this is just love. This is just love. We're gonna taste this. Don't do this at home. Give me a spoon, please. My man.
I'm already ready. You see that?
That's sous chef. So now we're gonna see. We're gonna taste.
Chef, shall we?
Yeah, go ahead. I'm right with you.
Cheers.
Clink, clink.
Oh, man.
Yeah. That's the spice it needed, I told you. Hot spice. Hot spice loving. Hot spice loving. That's what we call hot spice loving. It's nothing but going down. It's going down up in here today. Let's do this thing.
Okay. So right here, we're going into making the batter for the hush puppies. So we have a plantain. The reason why I'm adding the plantain, to give it a little body and the egg to hold it. We have this little secret mix, my grandmama mix. I can't tell you about the grandmama mix yet. So to be continued on that. Our buttermilk, and then we have some shrimp that we're gonna put in there. The shrimp is not up here yet, but it's coming.
Tell us basically what's in the grandmama mix though. Is it cornmeal, is it flour? You ain't gotta tell us all the secrets.
I won't tell you the ratio.
Tell us a little bit about
it. I won't tell you the ratio. So we have flour, got cornmeal, garlic powder, right. Onion powder, salt,
ooh,
flour,
love.
Cornmeal.
Ooh.
Cornmeal.
Don't tell nobody.
Cornmeal.
That's a love.
Yeah, all right. Yeah, so it's that love. So I can't give you the ratios, but that's in there. So I have these plantains right here. I'm gonna clip the tip, or if you want, you actually can break the bottom and just peel like so, peel it backwards.
Peels just like a banana, huh?
Yeah.
How does it taste? Does it taste similar to a banana?
It's a lot more savory than a banana. You know, the sweetness ratio is not as sweet. So you actually can use this in form of a potato, actually. You know what I'm saying? It have that same texture, kind of that same variation. So if you want to, you can actually make a fresh garlic puree, roasted plantain puree type thing. Ooh, you Lord. In the game.
Why?
And you know why?
Ooh.
Cause we can.
Okay, let's go.
So right here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna dice these plantains. I'm coming like so. And there's nothing crazy that you're looking for. You're just looking for dice. And you're gonna run through like that. It doesn't have to be in uniform because we're gonna puree this. But I'm just cutting like that. And you can slide that thing on up like so. You always gotta season that water.
You want me to drop these in the water for you,
yes,
Chef?
Sir. Oh, all right. Man.
You ain't even gotta move. So we just gonna drop these in the water, that hot boiling water. How long we gonna let them boil for, Chef?
So we're gonna let this boil roughly for about 10 to 15 minutes, or due to the consistency that you're looking for to mash. So, but what we're looking for is mash pan. So we have two eggs that we're going into our dredge for our hush puppies. So this dredger hand is pretty much the mix that I'm gonna be making for you.
Okay, that's what you drop your shrimp in.
Righteous.
All right then.
So right here, we got our two eggs in the bowl. We're gonna whisk that. I like to whisk mine in layers and add to that.
Y'all see the flick of the wrist?
Look at it. So right here, I have some buttermilk. I'm gonna add about maybe a cup. And then from there, we can gonna add to get a correct consistency. But from there, I say I'm mixing layers. You know what I'm saying?
You hear me saying?
That grandma.
That grandma.
We're gonna add all that. And the reason why I go wet first, because it prevents a lot of clumps. And then you
so you're just looking for a certain consistency, almost like what, wet sand? What type of consistency?
Actually, the consistency you're looking for, I'll say it'll be closer to cornbread.
Right.
So right here, I'm gonna add maybe a quarter cup more.
Okay, a little splash more buttermilk. Mm. Why do you use buttermilk instead of regular milk? What buttermilk?
Well,
because I use buttermilk too. I'm all about buttermilk.
So, buttermilk for me, it has this tanginess, it has this fat into it, and it has this silky texture that it adds to your mixture. It leavens it up, you know what I'm saying? It makes your cornbread or your hush puppy or your biscuits, it makes it rise in love a little bit more. You feel me?
More fluffy.
Yeah,
more love.
More love. is the consistency right here that I'm looking for. So, also remind you, we're gonna add one more thing to it. We're gonna add the plantains, the pureed plantains and shrimp. All right, so now our plantains are done. They're to a soft consistency where we need them now. So from here, we're going to strain them
with the mush.
Phone checker, swinging sword lecture, closing down the sector, supreme neck protector. Better want him, kid, Mr. Messer. Warming pot, bout to blow his lid from the pressure. Too hot for TV, for cheesy. Too many wanna be hard, be easy. It's all in together, going all out together.
These plantains, sexy, man. We need to put them in the refrigerator. We need to just cool them off at room temperature.
We can let them come to room temperature.
All right. So we gonna put them in this little nice little bowl right here. Let it just come down to room temperature.
All right, so right here we have our shrimp right here, local shrimp from Charleston, South Carolina, out that water. Or how we say in that country, we about to go across that water and get some shrimp. You know, I normally go to Georgetown and get some things like that, but we got this from Starving Marvels right down the road, D Road. So right here, got a little salt. Don't need a lot. Less is more in a lot of ways. So I have one of my favorite seasons, complete season. I keep it real.
Little herbs, little right. Salt, little pepper, little garlic. It really does add a lot of flavor.
Parsley, basil, you know what I'm saying? We're going to take a little sprinkle of that. And just to give it a little kick, a little more spice, on the back end, a little cayenne pepper.
And we're going to put these shrimp on the grill?
Yeah, we're going to put this shrimp on the grill. See what this grill going to do, baby?
What is it going to do?
It's going to give it that sexy smoke.
All right.
And I'm going to leave it there.
That extra flavor. Drop the mic. Yeah, good looking. Good shout out to Melissa from Atlantic Food Service for the bowls, the spatulas, everything we're using for this season. Nothing but love. Appreciate it.
Much love. So right here, I'm going to form my garnish. So we're going to have an onion and parsley salad to garnish the plantain and shrimp. So right here, I'm going to do a julienne cut. You see, I already have this thing peeled. So I'm going to cut off the back end. And then I'm going to do some chiffonade cuts. Julienne cuts. So these julienne cuts, I'm going to come at them like this. And that's all I need right there.
So we're about to do a little bit of shark steak. Shark steak is something that they eat a lot down here. First thing we want to do with a shark steak is, I want to cut the bone out. The bone is normally circular, and I want to cut the bloodline out. The bloodline is a little bit bitter. Next thing we want to do is we want to get our marinade ready. Our marinade is going to bring out the flavor in the shark steak just so it doesn't taste so fishy. Sometimes I like to marinate with Asian flavors. Sometimes I marinate with Southern flavors. Sometimes I marinate with Hispanic flavors, but I'm just all about flavor. Flavor is the love. Put our chopped up garlic in here. Our garlic, a little bit minced up. It's right on top of there. We got lemon thyme out of the garden. Right on top of here, we got our ginger that we've peeled and cleaned. Last but not least, we got a Thai chili pepper. Add a little bit of heat to it. I love heat. A little bit of onion for savory. Just a little bit, because we're going to use the rest of the onion with our spinach and our stuff on the side. We're going to add our citrus. Our citrus is going to brighten up the swordfish, add a little bit more flavor when we put it on the grill, bring out the sugars in it. So we're going to squeeze one half a lemon. I'm going to squeeze one lime, a half a lime, on top of the swordfish. Then we're going to add some coconut oil, probably about a tablespoon of coconut oil, just so everything coats it real nice and fresh. Salt. We salt everything we do, just like Chef Marcus said. If you're not seasoning, you ain't doing nothing. My motto is, what it tastes like. You use so many crazy different ingredients, so many special expensive ingredients, but if it don't taste like nothing, then really what are you doing? What does it taste like?
Nothing.
Nothing. Last but not least, for our marinade, we're gonna hit them with a little bit of this fresh pickle juice from the farm, this hot pepper pickle juice. Add a little bit of zing to it. That zing, that tanginess, nothing but love. Chef Mark, can you hand me a spoon?
I sure can, I got
it. All right, I appreciate that, brother. Want to mix this stuff up in there. You want to let this marinate for about 10-15 minutes. It doesn't really take a long time to marinate fish or chicken. E5 marinate overnight, but fish, definitely not, because this will turn into ceviche. Now for the sweetness, a little bit of honey. All you want is a little bit, because we don't want it to be candy. We just want to cut that lemon juice, that little bit of sweetness. Stir it up with your spoon. Put it in the refrigerator for 30 minutes. Light up your grill. Let your marinade do its work. Time for love. Next thing we want to do is we want to get our okras and tomatoes ready for our side. Fresh okra out of the garden. Just want to slice them in half. Most of the time, when you see okra in the South, it's normally fried okra and breaded. I like to pan simmer okra in a nice hot skillet. A little bit of garlic, a little bit of salt. That's all you need. But this time, I'm gonna make almost like a salad with the okra, tomatoes, the pickled veggie, the onions. I'm gonna start off by sauteing the onion. Then I'm gonna put the okra in the pan, and I'm gonna finish it with the tomatoes. And then last but not least, a little bit of the hot pepper juice. Next, we're gonna julienne our onion. Then we're gonna cut our tomatoes in half. These are tomatoes that have been aged on the vine. As you can see, they're a little bit darker and richer, but the flavor in them is ridiculous. All right, last, our pepper. All right, our grill should be nice and hot. Our fish has been marinated, shrimp is all nice and seasoned. It's time for us to get out there on that grill, throw this stuff on there. Let's do it.
Tiger style.
The grill nice and hot. Flames are nice and bright. Fish has been marinated.
Shrimp has been marinated.
All nice and beautiful. All we need to do is throw these on the grill. We're not gonna cook them for that long because it's seafood and we don't want them to be dried out. I'm gonna get good grill marks on both sides of this. Cook it nice and tender, pull it off, and we're gonna be ready to eat, buddy.
I was trying to get it out of here. I want them dead presidents.
Back at it.
I want
them all this stuff in the bottom of this bowl. Spent. This stuff is going on this fish. So when it cooks, it's gonna cook
tight. I don't get tired.
While our fish and our shrimp is on the grill, next thing we want to do is we want to get our pan ready for our okra and onion and stuff like that. We just want to hit it with a little bit of coconut oil. The pan should be at medium high heat. When you know it's medium high, your grease will get legs is what they call it. When you turn it, you'll see it running down the side of the pan. We want to add our onions to the pan and our garlic. We don't want the pan on too high. We want it medium high because we don't want to scorch them. All we want to do is we want to caramelize the onions. Just a little sprinkle. You can smell the onions and the garlic in the air. This right here is gonna be serious. Remember, Melissa, for the pans, Atlantic Food Service, these brown pans, these nonstick pans, make everything so much easier. Season 2 is gonna be raw simply because of the pans. Once your onions get about translucent, next thing you wanna do is, you wanna add your okra. Just pump them right in the pan. We got Big Marcus out there on the grill right now, checking that swordfish, checking that shrimp. Everything's starting to sizzle now. You can hear it rolling. You start to see a little bit of color on that okra. What you want to see is, you want to see that sear nice and good on the okra. You want to cook them soft, but not too soft. We don't want to get them slimy. Okra has a tendency to get slimy. We got the tomatoes, okra, onion, nice peppers. Love, nothing but color, nothing but healthiness, that Malabar spinach. We got these overripened tomatoes, the okra, peppers, cayenne chilies. Just, man, it's just love. Let's do this thing. Woo. The shark steak and shrimp should be about done. Been on here about 10 minutes. Should be nice and tender. How I like to test mine is just take the tongue and just pull a little piece off, as you can see. Nice and tender, number love. Man, we eating good tonight.
Yeah, we are.
Now we back at. So right here I have our smoked shrimp, our plantain, and right here we gotta mash these plantains. So what I got right here, while it's still hot, you wanna take your spoon and you wanna mash. We added the plantain
to the hush puppy mix. So the reason why I added that plantain to the hush puppy mix, because we're making plantain and shrimp hush puppies, but this plantain is going to give it some body. So we smoked it, have a nice sexy smoked shrimp flavor right there. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this shrimp and I'm going to give it a rough chop. And we want all that shrimp in there, you know what I'm saying?
Nothing but shrimp flavor.
Nothing but shrimp.
We're not going to skimp the people.
Each ever. And every single bite. One. So right here I have my smoked shrimp in there and I add a little chiffonade parsley in there. So we're just going to mix that so everything is incorporated very well. All the shrimp is coated. Everything is nice and love in that pot. How them boys say? I got greens, beans, potatoes, tomatoes, yam, whatever, whatever, whatever.
All name it. All that.
You name it! You name it!
Alright, girl, let's go. Talk to
so
me now.
So right here, what we're doing, we're not doing your actually deep fried hush puppy. So this will be more of a shallow fry, or you can kind of call it, this may be a Johnny cake towards you, or anything of that nature, but this is more of a shallow fry to me. And we're going to make love to this pan. Right, so now I'm going to test to see if it's where I need it to be. So right now I have it on a low heat right now. Earlier I got my pan hot and I don't want it too hot because if so, I'm going to burn. So right now I'm going to test to see if I'm in the right area.
About how much grease you put in the pan?
I'm looking about a half an inch.
Okay.
You know, okay. So we right here, look like we working with something right there. So
yeah, man, that grease look hot, Bubba.
So right here, we're gonna put a dollop of the mixture in here. So I'm just coming with this, another spoon, and I'm just going on top like so.
Hear that sizzle?
Yeah, baby.
Man, this is new and improved. We trying to create new things out here, man.
It's all about making love to the food. Right, you know what I'm saying? Using your brain, using what you got. Just letting it go, flicking the wrist on that thing. Man. So,
I'd like to thank everybody for joining us for another episode of Cookin' with Steez, the Low Country Edition. We got this shark steak banging with this okra, these tomatoes, these pickled peppers, all this love. We got this dang old Johnny cakes right here, these hush puppy love with this shrimp.
Love yours.
Onions,
parsley, balsamic glaze with this.
Love yours.
That's all I can say.
And we've been cooking with Steez, man. Thank y'all for joining us for another episode. Episode 5, season 2.
Season 2, episode 5. Don't be sleeping on your level, cause it's beauty in the struggle, nigga. It's beauty in the struggle, nigga. It's beauty in the struggle, ugliness in the success. Hear my words and listen to my signal of distress. I grew up in the city and know sometimes we had less. Compared to some of my niggas down the block, man, we were blessed. And life can't be no fairy tale, no once upon a time. But I be goddamn if a nigga don't be trying. So tell me, mama, please, why you be drinking all the time? Cause all the pain he brought you still linger in your mind. Cause pain still lingers on mine. On the road to riches, listen, this is what you find. The good news is, nigga, you came a long way. The bad news is, nigga, you went the wrong way.
Man, y'all better stop playing with me, man.